on this farm, the moo and the ba and all that other stuff. Yet something is wrong. The schooled ear detects a false note. A cock-a-doodle-doo is different, deeper, more dragging, more boring than usual. It comes from Farmer Gabriel. Cock-a-doodle-doo, calls Farmer Gabriel, trying to lure the hens out of the stall with his cry. And they follow the false cock-a-doodle-doo out of habit, out of stupidity, or because they want to get out anyway. The last hen is hardly out of the stall when Farmer Gabriel rolls up his shirt sleeves. The old stall is completely rotten and going to get a new concrete floor. Farmer Gabriel has a lot of work ahead of him. He cleans the stall, sets the form, mixes the concrete, spreads it in the stall and smooths it out. And while Farmer Gabriel is working by the sweat of his brow, the hens are scratching and picking in the bright sunshine, and maybe they are sweating too. When the sun sets, the work is finished. Thirsty, he makes his way to the inn, the Trumpet, to drink a beer. The limbs are very weary after such a long work day, but not the tongue. That's why the farmers sit in the Trumpet and drink. Beer in return beer, talk in return talk. There have to be discussions. In a nearby town, an 8-year-old girl was molested by a man 20 years older. The talk in the Trumpet revolved around the question of what could be done to protect the children. Chop off head. Farmer Gabriel was of the opinion that it was, of course, terrible for such a little girl to be defenseless and faced with such a big fellow. That was like 4 against 1. But still, one should consider that it was clearly a case of lesser guilt, a case of sick sexual instinct, and a sick sexual instinct requires retreatment and not punishment. Don't chop off head. Farmer Gabriel was of this opinion until 11 o'clock, and then his tongue was tired. Farmer Gabriel made his way home. He was as tired as a dog, yet he was not to sleep for a long while. A terrible surprise awaited him in the chicken stall. He had forgotten to lock the chicken stall with its fresh concrete. And when he went by habit to the Trumpet, the hens followed their own habit and went into the stall and stood in the fresh concrete, which, according to its habit, hardened after a few hours. There was no doubt. The chicken stall had a new floor, and in this floor were stuck the chickens, damned to motionlessness. Farmer Gabriel recognized the situation, and with a heavy heart, he knew what he had to do. In the pale light of the lantern, he set a kettle of water on to boil. He turned to the page in the cookbook entitled Chicken Sausage, got a scythe, and went into the stall. What did he plan to do? The next morning I saw pairs of little yellow stumps sticking out of the concrete floor. And that at my age, I'm 12 years old and broken for life.